I'm waiting here. It's continuing to make sure that the players cannot clip through any of the geometry. Usually, well, the players are not able to move in the x-axis, so they would always stay in roughly in this lane, so to speak. So yeah, where this lane mostly. But because there's a lot of things going on here with physics and such as the rock falling, we don't want the rock to clip through any of the geometry here, unless, well, not at least not where it doesn't seem logical. So, for instance, let's snap him back on. So, for instance, somewhere over here doesn't make a lot of sense where something like this over here, which is a bit lower, makes relatively more sense. The rock will probably never get here, but because we're using physics, you never know what it might do. And even when you constrain movement, sometimes it has a tendency to it has a tendency to still do unpredictable behavior. Let's get a few more over here. Instead of this one, let's just copy this one over. And over here, it might be possible to see through here. So let's just quickly cover that up. I will relay this later back to the artist who may do the art classes after this, or at least the main art class is already done. Let's see, because there also might be the possibility that you are able to see this from over here, which doesn't make a whole lot of sense. So I would say the best way to cover this up would be to use the ground planes from over here, just so that it doesn't obstruct any of the. We could use rocks, but the ground plane seems a bit more elegant in that sense, so it doesn't obstruct any of the boundaries of where the arena actually is and where the wall crawler actually jumps on. So Maybe we do something like this. Okay, this seems to be reasonably, well, this seems to be all right. Okay, so let's save this. The main idea is because we are streaming these levels into the main level, this is essentially fetched and streamed into the main level, mainly because we don't want any loading screens, or at least obvious loading screens. So we're streaming in every single object, or every single level rather, one piece at a time. Let's see. Because in the earlier videos that I made today, the main goal was to make sure that this would lead in perfectly with, or this at least we could implement this into the main level seamlessly. So I needed to make, or I needed to make sure that this level leads into the other levels as well. So there's a, and what I mean by that is making sure that the players are actually able to get into the area, so they are led to the area and then eventually also exit it. So the main important thing here is that we clearly define the boundaries here, and the artists that is responsible for this level, or at least the art in the environment for this level, Eilish knows this. I'm just creating a basic layout, and we discussed this as well, of course. Let's create maybe two more rows of these. All right. Okay, so just a quickly making sure that everything works. So the main things that I did today was making sure that these doors work, and these are Metany actors, but they're based on proximity. The main thing here is to make sure that one player cannot get stuck while the other. And the other player can get stuck. So let's put this to close now. And then over here is where the next trigger is. And I am able to actually get stuck over here. So probably what we need to do in that case is close entry door. number 5. And that is linked to a Matini actor, or a Matinee actor. And the thing is, there are a few things that we can do. This is the wrong one. And actually, I think this is legacy, so we can delete it. But there are a few ways to do this correctly. One of the ways is creating safety checks, so the doors will only close if both players are overlapping with a certain trigger. But that creates a lot more work for relatively simple. So instead of doing something like that, well, I guess you would still need it. Well, let's first start with changing the animations for now. So this one, I'm pretty sure that you can't you can't make it over there. Then again, there's a problem where you actually are able to get the shield, the other player is stuck here because there are no safety checks. So that is a bit of a problem where the shield player is still here. They can't actually get over there. What we can do to rectify that is, yeah, in that sense, we actually need to make safety checks. But let's first speed up the. Yeah, I guess you could just change these to maybe half a second. So this one, close that one in half a second. And then the second one, which is this right now, I guess you could also make that one half of a second. But the main thing is, if it actually is being played over here. And right now they are reversed. So that is not the problem. The problem is that these were reversed. So let's go to this one. Okay. Yeah, so previously in earlier videos, I kind of made a check for this already, making sure that these are at least faster than I had anticipated. But I see that now there's a problem with the way I set these up. So, yeah, these are changed back now. Let's see, because here they are reversed, and these are basically the same Metzny actors that open the door, which lasts about 5 seconds in terms of duration, and basically, at a certain point, once players overlap with this trigger, it basically plays that same Matini actor, but then actually reverses it. So instead of opening the door, it actually closes, but there's no way to actually change the duration of any of these in blueprints directly. So unfortunately, we need to make entirely new animations for these, which is not that hard, as you can essentially just copy the ones that you already have and just change the keyframe animations from close to open. So you switch them around. Close the door. The same for this one. Keep forgetting that that is a reverse node instead of a play node. So these are the ones that we actually want. The same one over here. This should be door close number two, so that should be this one. Yes. Let me just target it over here. And then let's see, because it opens this one, it opens or closes this one, it closes that one, and then on trigger overlap, it closes this one. On actor begin overlap, it closes this one, which is number six, I believe. Closed door entry number six. Closed door entry number six. Closed door entry number six. Yes, so that is that one. Play trapdoor close. Door close three. So this is actually the right. These did have the right nets in the actors. Okay, so let's try this. This mainly these are based on opening and closing doors in such a way. It's mainly based on distance as well as okay, can we actually get to it in time? So let's say I think this is the overlap. Yeah, so there's no way we are able to make it. And then here's an overlap as well. See if we are able to. No, so there's no way we'll be able to make that. The only problem right now that is still in here is, and this is a bit of a problem, of course, is that as you already saw there, the shield player is able to get stuck here. As in, and there's no way for the shield player to actually get out of there. Unless you open it, but there's no actual way to open it, and that's not really the point in this case. So, what we need to do is we need to make an if statement saying, okay, if both of these players have overlapped with the door or with the trigger, then you may proceed to play that animation, or at least close or open the doors, and we have to carefully place these trigger volumes to make sure that the players are not able to get over here. And as I already tested just now, there's no way the players will be able to get to any of these doors in time. So changing the duration for those proved to be right. A good thing to do. Okay, so let's see. Let's change this comment over here because it's not closed doors and overlap. Let's say, just keep it like this for now, so we don't actually reverse it anymore. And this is always kind of a, well, it shouldn't be much of a problem because you can have a lot of variables for this, but you only really want two that's already made here. So we need for every single time a trigger is overlapped, it will basically do this. So we set the, we set a Boolean is shield pair overlapped. We set that to true. Then we do the same for the beam character. And set that to true. And then so over here we need to create a branch. That says, okay, if both of these are true, then actually play the animation. Actually, we probably don't have to. No, you know what, actually. I'm thinking ahead of myself here. But basically it's okay, you get these booleans overlapped is true. Get an end boolean. The shields get connected to this pin over here, and so the condition right now is if the player has overlapped. If the beam player is overlapped with this area, then set this boolean to true. If the shield character is overlapped with this area, then set this shield player overlapped boolean to true. And if both of these are true, then you may execute this or play the animation in this case. I need to clean this a bit up since the main thing over here is that we need to reset this node as well. Because, and that's the problem with using multiple or just a few variables. You need to reset these. Which is actually kind of a good thing because you don't want separate you don't want separate variables for for each unique instance. I'm curious where I'm actually using this. Oh yeah, that's right. Okay, yeah. That makes sense. So let's say set beam character. We set this to false again. Then we set this to shields overlaps to true, and we set these to false. Again. So if we overlap with this closed door one, then it shoots quickly close the door, but then also change the variable back, or reset the variable rather. Let's just make sure that all of these are. Yeah, okay. Does this make sense? We know that this is right because. Just to be sure that we are actually correct. See, it doesn't really matter that much for opening, but closing is the main part. And just to be sure, right now the beam player cannot only. As you can see here, this trigger is not updated yet, but the trigger for this one is over here. So right now it doesn't actually, or isn't actually able to do any of that. Now, well, I'm Well, I'm thinking about this right now. We actually have to. Or do we? No, actually, we don't. Right now, here it actually disabled these. And we might actually want to move this trigger area, or trigger volume rather, a bit up. So we are completely sure that the players won't be able to do this. Let's save that. But this is the most important part, that we actually set the. Let's structure this a bit more. The most important part of this is that we set or reset these booleans, because we use these multiple times within the blueprint. And a lot depends on these. So if we were able. If we left these on true, then everything else would break in terms of the doors. So it's quite important that we get those right. And then after this, of course, you can just copy these over. And again, because it's a co-op game, you have to take a lot more care into, or well, you have to be more careful and take more care in making sure that one player is not able to open or close a door, which may render the other player stuck. And in single player games, you don't really have that problem unless you use some form of companion AI. But then again, probably that companion AI also has a way to open or close those doors. But usually in single player games, if there's an automatic door that opens on based on your proximity, then obviously you don't have to take as much. You don't have to really think about that. So let's skip these again. Okay, before we do that, let's get all of this and move it over here. Let's get all of this. So yeah, the blueprints can become quite large in that sense, but there are ways to go around it, mainly by just maybe creating macros, which might have been a good idea in that sense, because a lot of this is repeated. But yeah, next time. Especially this part where you overlap with a certain. So actually what you could just do is get these and collapse it into a macro. And that's basically it. And it would ju work just fine. This is door, entry door, closed door, entry 5. But if we were to just get these and turn these into a macro, you would see that these just work. We open it right here. Opens. Opens. The only main thing that I now notice is that, so yeah, that macro worked, as you could see. But for now, we'll... already saved. Well, in that case, let's just... No, we'll keep it like this for now. But the only thing that I mentioned or noticed just now is that it's really likely that the wall or the players are able to actually get through this. Let's see, because this is based on overlap with both of the players. Yeah. So probably the door, this door closes at the same time as this animation is being played. So we probably want to change that. Where this door place beforehand. So I'm pretty sure that Okay, I will deal with that later. Because I know how to fix that, but it's mainly a point of just doing some more things. Yeah, so the player is able to get stuck over here. So there are a few things that we could do. You know what? We'll just make this. .5 in terms of delay. We got that. We got that. Possess. Okay, so let's see. It seems possible. Let's just. Okay, so instead of these, what we actually need to do is. Okay, so we've got these on trigger or trigger close door one. Close door one. So we need a small check here, or end overlap rather. An actor end overlap. We can get these. Beam. Okay, no, this is terrible. And then if it overlaps or it ends the overlap, then we set these to false. Let's compile. Wait, I forgot something here. This. So right now, one opens it, but let's say here's the trigger, and we move back, and here's the trigger. And we move back, it still is possible to do that. That is interesting. Why is that still possible? Oh. Okay, but how does that? let's just get some of the screen over here. Okay, so we open this one, we open these, and we open this one. Okay, so on application over here, it says yes, okay, so it's now set to true. If we set it to false, it should set... Okay, that is probably not what you want to do. Because that's a bit silly. This node wasn't connected. So we can check it right now. Open both of these. And so the beam collides with it now, but it doesn't do anything. But it's set to true. But right now it's set to false because we actually... And now we set it here, we set it to is false on end overlap. And so if the shield player something like that right now, it doesn't actually work. Unless you go very fast, then triggers become very unreliable. But if both of them are there, then it closes. So there's no way for the players to actually break the system in that sense. And then so we can do the same for this door. So that would be end overlap on actor end overlap. You get these same notes. Make sure that it actually casts two, or that the trigger actually tries to send a ray cast to the specific actors. Okay, that was... Oh god. Exclude these. Close for entry 6. Yes, we also need that for this one, because otherwise it is very well possible that one player over here, so let's say the beam player is over here and the shield player is over there, but the beam player is already overlapped with that, then the beam player is very likely to just get stuck over there. So again, we need a safety check for that, so on actor end overlap. Oh, we already have a safety check for that. So we can put that over here. Let's check. Okay, so overlap, true. This should be overlap false. So if we now overlap with this part, it doesn't actually trigger it. And now they're both set to false. Now shield player set to true, beam player set to true, so now it should close that door. Okay, that's very good. Just to make sure that the characters are actually not able to do anything, or at least not able to get over this spot. Let's just quickly test it one more time. I'm still a bit hesitant to call that final. It seems like it is still possible. It seems very likely that you are able to, or one of the players is able to get stuck over there. Yeah, okay, this seems a lot more realistic. Something interesting going on with the mesh over here. Let's see, oh yeah, I see why. Let's increase it just a bit. Okay, just a quick recap again. For opening, it doesn't really matter which character does that. Okay, so here's the trigger for closing this door. Now it's set to true for a beam. Now it's set to false. Or it should be set to false, rather. Shield character overlaps with it. Doesn't do anything, so we know these are both sets of false right now. If they both overlap, they close. Same with this one, it should be set to false right now. It's set. Okay, that is interesting. Let's take a look. Entry, begin, end, true and close. Okay, this shouldn't actually do anything that breaks it. Oh, wait a minute, I think it's a problem with, no, it's a problem with the animation, actually. It doesn't have anything to do with the triggers. The triggers are fine. Although you have to be careful with triggers, as they are very unreliable on higher speeds. Or higher speeds. On high movement. And remember, because this one, I think it's set to door close number 2. I think this is the one is still set to 1. No. Door close number 2. So which one is actually or is it just that fast? Because that's also a possibility, of course. But at least we know that these triggers work. And then again, it shouldn't matter too much. Yeah, so the lead designer mentioned that this could happen. And I think the reason why this happens is because it checks too late whether or not all the legs are destroyed. So let's actually check that. But for this, we don't actually need the level blueprint anymore. We need the BP. And I'm pretty sure it has something to do with here. And I think it has to, yeah. So there's the second of delay. And that is what causes it to, because basically what it does is, okay, sets delay, okay, if all of these are, set simulate physics, and then if these are actually, if this one is actually, if this leg is actually destroyed, then sets the material, then set simulate physics, so that's what makes the leg seem like it actually falls off, and then this delay is what causes it actually, because, and I'm not quite sure why this delay is here. I'm actually not too sure why this delay is here. But the reason why it does that, as you could see, basically if all of these six legs are destroyed, then it should no longer rotate. So the main idea right now, or at least how it's programmed, is okay, if the wall crawler is, for instance, on this wall, and you stun it while it's leaping or jumping towards this wall, it will stay in this position, so the players are able to actually hit it, hit the legs from this side instead of over here. But as you could see just now in that example, the wall crawler actually rotated in a way in which it still protects its weak point, and at that point it stays in that state because of the way it's programmed. If all legs are destroyed, then it should no longer it should no longer be able to jump anywhere. And the reason why it is still able to rotate is because of this. Because of this second delay, and within that second delay might be the just the split second in which it actually decides to rotate versus should I not rotate. And I'm still not quite sure why these are. Well, I know why, but the question is really why is it placed over here? Because this is essentially right in the. Right in the so-called execution. In the execution flow. So it actually has a second delay before it actually notifies the rest of the script of, oh, okay, it actually declares over here that, okay, yes, this leg has actually been destroyed. And that is what causes the wall crawler to rotate and stay in that position infinitely. So I think. And the reason why this delay is here is so that you could see the is that you could actually see it fall off. But now I'm contemplating whether or not or where I should put this instead. Because you still want that loop, so to speak. But I think instead of I think if you get just got all of these, delete them, and executed them, like, and then link these together. That should get rid of it. Or, well, yeah, that does get rid of it. But then we still need to. And this is going to cause a bit of a aesthetic disorder in the blueprint, but oh well. So we can still do that, but before we actually set any delays here, we have to first specify, okay, it actually has been hit. Because otherwise it will affect the gameplay in quite a dramatic way, as in you're actually not able to kill the wall crawler. So instead of having this delay first, you should first declare that, okay, I have been hit if all the legs have been hit, which is what is checked over here. If that is true, then yes, you are able to execute all of this. And this is the most important part, whereas this is secondary, really. This is all cosmetic. Well, it's cosmetic in player feedback, but if this fails, then it's less of an issue than if this happens, because even if this fails, as in maybe, which it will not happen, but if this would fail, then in any case, this would still work, and so it wouldn't rotate like we saw just now. So we need to target these, we need to target. We target this one. We need to retarget that one. Retarget this one. Retarget this one. So right now, let's clean this up a bit. Connect these together. I'm considering whether or not there's a way to make this less of a. With blueprints, I kind of want to strive for the most clear blueprints. Always as clear as possible, but sometimes that is not really possible unless you do the entire or redo the entire script, which is not really necessary for a relatively small thing that this is. So if we were to save all of this, check these. Usually, this is not what is first happening, it's actually an entire bug.
Bye.
Yeah, that seems to work. So it was purely that delay of 1 second, that 1 split second that essentially broke the wall crawler in quite a significant way, actually. It depends, of course, on how many times this happens, but the thing is, initial playtests already showed that usually it's very late in the last cycle where the leg, the final leg's actually destroyed, where this became a lot more apparent because of that 1 second delay in which it actually checks whether or not. Let's get notepad over here. But basically, it checks whether or not okay, am I hit by the beam? Am I hit by the beam? And then point and make sure that that actually is declared to the following script, rather than okay, the leg has been hit over here, but now I'm gonna wait 1 second until I actually declare this to the rest of the script. And in this right here is essentially where the wall crawler is able to rotate. And because it rotates after it has been rotated, then it actually executes that script. But if it's already rotated and all the legs have been hit, so all legs destroyed, all legs, destroyed, then at that point it actually cannot rotate anymore. So instead of this, it will eventually just stay like this, and the weak points will always be over here rather than be exposed over here. So that's the main point that we just fixed over here. And obviously this, but that's all debug. So yeah, a few things before we actually, well, actually we didn't check the other portion of this, which is after the wall crawler has been defeated. And this would actually be a good time to try this out as well. This is also an opportunity to make sure that the bug has actually been fixed. See, so it just stays in there. and you hit it, and once you actually hit it, the wall crawler should be defeated, and that's when it actually opens up this door over here. Based on the proximity of the players, and because these will always stay open, it's not as much of a problem as these or the previous ones, which had to close based on the proximity again. But also make sure that the players are not actually able to get stuck there. So this is more of a more elegant way of doing it, I would say. Although, one problem that I just noticed here is that these don't actually simulate any physics right now, and I'm not quite sure why. But this is basically signposting, saying, okay, something has actually happened here. And actually, come to think of it, we probably would want these to be over here. After the wall crawler has been defeated, these two door opens, and so there's basic signposting of saying, okay, well, these rocks are falling down, so there's probably something up above. But now they're called BP physics rocks, so I'm gonna find them inside the level blueprints. It would be BP physics rock. Okay, these should simulate physics on event tick, but they don't actually do anything. But the question is why. And I think why that is because it's all based on event tick, which is basically in every frame do this. Right, let's check that for a moment. No, they don't simulate any physics, which is interesting, because they should. So why don't they? This one does. This one does. Very interesting. We'll just keep these over here. I'm just going to replace them. So instead of these, we just get the reference to the new actors. Kind of to move this node a little bit. Actually target it. And so I'm gonna put this on the second screen right now. I'm gonna quickly debug my way through the wall crawler fight. If I was able to move the characters. Okay, I moved too fast. That's what happens with triggers. Especially if other level blueprints or blueprints opened, it can become quite. Wait a minute. Okay, yeah, that kind of makes sense. Shoot. Are we going to fix that? Okay, so that problem may still occur. So how do we fix that? But even afterwards, if it is on there, well, actually, I think I know how to do this, but that case, what we would need is. Okay, so one thing at a time. First, let's try to defeat the wall crawler again, because I first want to test all the physics related things, and don't move too fast through these things if you're using triggers. Let's move. Okay, so these kind of work, but no, I don't want to edit them. But we just need to not choose the door. Just have to make sure that they are not there, essentially. And then okay, so these all simulate physics already, which is what we don't want. We should simulate physics afterwards. So let's just quickly check this again, and then afterwards I will. Let's get out of here. Thank you. Wait. Oh, wait a minute. I think I know. I know where the problem is for the rotating as well. So it's not only there, it's... Okay, so those rocks were great. So what I just noticed over here is that there is a delay here. And then, okay, so what does it do afterwards? Why is there even a delay there? So the delay is set material. Okay, can we not have the material there? Or the delay there? The material is fine, but the delay, no. Okay, let's try this again. Because all these delays have to go. I use them... I was using them for feedback, but if they're breaking... You're breaking the wall color in a class A way, then as in you can't actually defeat it because of it. And then obviously some things have to go. They're not major, I mean. Okay, so that wasn't really... Yeah, for testing purposes like this, you kind of have to fill. Oh, let's get out of here. Okay, I think we fixed it. It seems to be fixed. But just to be sure, and then the, yeah, right. But just to be sure, I'm gonna create a safety check either way. Which means we still need a. Well, first of all, what we need to do is go to the event graph. And then say. Actually, we need a custom event. Custom event over here. Just before it actually declares, okay, this leg has been destroyed. So actually, we actually want to have it over. I'm curious where we actually shoot. Where we should actually put this. Because this is for Wallcrawler death. And this is actually for the weak point, but in any case, this should be. I think it should be here. All legs destroyed, because this is only event 6, so all legs destroyed. Actually, we already have a. Wait, we already have that. Yeah, so, but if it's true. Yeah, but this goes through all the motions right here, so, okay, so instead of doing that, we just create a safety, another branch here, so. Create a branch, and. So this is false. This. All legs destroyed, and if that is true, then we set the actor sets actor rotation. Wait. Set actor rotation. Okay, let's. That extra rotation. And then on the left wall orientation, that should be the right wall orientation then. So then we get this. But in that case, you would have to check for every single frame whether or not. That is true, right? Does that make sense? Yeah, so if you overlap with this area and all legs are destroyed, then set right wall. Right? That seems to be logical. But okay, let's save before something goes horribly wrong. Let's get the wall crawler to the left. Over here.
Thank you.
Okay, so actually this didn't make it work at all. So what's the difference? What the hell? So, okay. Okay, so it works for no, can you please not do that? Okay, so
thank you.
Yeah, or what we could do is okay, so it has 8 seconds to recover. What if 8 of those seconds actually? But it's 8 seconds to recover. What if 6 of those seconds you can actually hit it? Oh God, but how do you?